Okay. And the basic definition feature required to define probability. So today we'll see the definition of probability. So first definition of probability is the classical definition of probability. Classical definition of probability. What classical definition of probability says let capital E be a random experiment. Capital E be a random experiment and capital S be the sample space of E consisting of n number of equally likely points n number of equally likely points. Okay, E is a random experiment. The sample space S of capital E consist of n number of equally likely points. Okay. Let suppose A be any event so obviously A will be a subset of the sample space. A be any event connected with capital E. Let A be any event. A is a subset of capital S connected with E consisting of consist of M, obviously M is less than N, number of M number of equally likely points, M number of, that is this M is out of this N numbers, okay, or out of this N points, it consists of M number of those equally likely points. So therefore, the probability of the event capital A can be defined as the probability event capital A is a number denoted by PA and is defined as thank you. PA is equal to the number of points in the event A divided by total number of points in the event space, M by N. Okay. P of A is defined by M by N. That is the number of points favorable to the event A divided by total number of points in the event space. Okay. Number of points favorable. So this is actually number of points favorable to the event favorable to A divided by total number of points in the sample space. Okay, so this is the classical definition of probability. Okay, so this example of classical definition of probability is, suppose we want to, we are taking the example of rolling a die. Here the sample space consists of 6 possibilities, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And suppose we want to find the probability of the event multiple of 3. Okay, so multiple of 3 means let us consider the example the sample space of the experiment of rolling a die is S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So total number of points in the sample space is S. And let capital A be the event multiple of capital A with the event multiple of 3. So therefore, what are the points favorable to the event A? The point 3 multiple of 3 means 3 comma 6. So by classical definition of probability, so therefore probability of A, classical definition of probability of A, this is equal to the number of points favorable to the event A. There are 2 points favorable to the event A divided by total number of points in the sample space, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 points are favorable to the are there in the sample space, so the probability is 1 by 3. So probability of A is equal to 1 by 3. So this is the classical definition of probability. Now, this classical definition of probability has some drawback. First drawback is, P of A is defined as P of A is equal to M by N. What is M? M is the number of points favorable to the event A, and N is the total number of points in the event space. Total number of points in the event space. Just a minute. Okay. Now here, if n is finite, then only we can use this definition. If n is infinite, we cannot use this definition. And we saw a sample space can consist of infinite number of points. Okay. So if the sample space consists of a finite number of points, we can use this definition of probability. But if the sample space consists of infinite number of points, we cannot use this definition of probability. Now, second serious drawback of this classical definition of probability is here the points must be equally likely. If the points are equally likely means the chance of occurrence of all the points are same. If the chance of occurrence of all the points are not same, we cannot use this definition of probability. Okay. So these are the drawbacks of this classical definition of probability. So to overcome this difficulty, we'll use frequency definition of probability. Frequency definition of probability. Now, what is frequency definition? Frequency definition of probability, it's the guideline of this frequency definition of probability is the experience, okay. Suppose you are throwing a coin. If you are throwing a coin, say 100 times, and out of that 100 times, you have observed that 70 times the event head has occurred. Okay. So, according to your observation, that is out of that 100 repetition of the experiment, 70 times the event A has occurred, the event A has occurred or head has occurred. So, you will say the probability of head is 70 by 100. That is 7 by 10. Okay. Now, so this is your experience. Someone else's experience may be different. Okay. Suppose out of that 100 repetition, he or she has observed that the event head has occurred only 40 times. So, but he or she will say that the probability of this head is 40 by 100. Okay. So that's the, that is, we are repeating an experiment large number of times and we are observing out of that large number of repetition of the experiment how many times the event A is occurring. Okay. A is occurring. In that case, we will say the probability of A will be the number of occurrence of the event A divided by the number of repetition of the experiment. Okay. So that's the frequency definition of probability. Let me write the frequency definition of probability. Let a random experiment suppose a random experiment capital E be repeated capital N number of times under uniform and identical condition. Identical conditions, suppose a random experiment E be repeated n number of times under uniform and identical conditions, and an event connected with capital E has occurred in A, it is less than N, number of E is a random experiment. We are repeating the random experiment a large number, n number of times, and out of this n repetitions, the event A has occurred n a number of times. Okay, n a number of times. The probability of the event A, then the probability capital A is denoted by PA, then the probability of the event A denoted by PA is defined as PA is equal to limit n tending to infinity, that is the number of repetition of the experiment tends to infinity, that is you are repeating the experiment a large number of times, na by n. So that's the frequency definition of probability. Probability of A is equal to limit n tending to infinity, na by n, where n tending to infinity, that we are repeating the experiment a large number of times. So that's the frequency definition of probability. Now this frequency definition of probability also have some drawbacks. The drawbacks of this frequency definition of probability is, see, we need to repeat, to use this definition, we need to repeat the experiment a large number of times, which is practically impossible, since we cannot repeat a experiment a large number of times, since there are some cost involved with each experiment. And also, for all the repetitions, we may not get the identical conditions. Okay, we may not get the identical conditions. So these are the drawbacks of this frequency definition of probability. Okay, now to overcome this difficulty, now we'll see the axiomatic definition of probability or axioms of probability, and that is the modern definition of probability. There is axiomatic definition of probability or axioms of probability. So let me write axiomatic definition of probability. Axiomatic definition of probability. So defined in this way. Let capital S be the sample space and capital A be any event associated with a random experiment capital E. Okay. Then the probability of the event A then the probability of the event A denoted by PA is defined as a real number satisfying the following axioms. Satisfying the following axioms. Number one, 0 less than or equal to P of A less than or equal to 1. That is, probability is a number lying between 0 and 1. Probability cannot be negative, okay? And probability cannot be greater than one. Number two, probability of the certain event is equal to one. Then number three, if capital A and capital B are mutually exclusive events, then probability A union B, that is either A or B, and since the events A and B are mutually exclusive, both are not possible. So probability A union B, this is equal to P of A plus P of B. Number three and number four, if A1, A2, AN, are a set of pairwise mutually exclusive events, mutually if A1, A2, AN dot 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 are a set of pairwise mutually exclusive events. Pairwise mutually exclusive means take any two, their intersection is 5. Suppose A1 intersection A2, that is equal to 5. A1 intersection A3 is equal to 5, and so on. A2 intersection A3 is equal to 5. Take any two different members from that set, their intersection will be 5. Okay. Events. So in that case, probability A1 union A2 union A3 union dot 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 union AN union dot dot dot. So this will be actually P of A1 plus P of A2 plus P of A3 dot 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 P of AN plus. So this is the axiomatic definition of probability. So that is the modern definition of probability. We will use this definition of probability. Probability is the number lying between 0 and 1. P of probability of A lies between 0 to 1. Probability of certain event is always equal to 1. Probability of certain event is always equal to 1. If A and B are mutually exclusive events, then probability A union B is equal to P of A plus P of B. And number 4, if A1, A2, dot 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 AN, dot dot dot, are a set of pairwise mutually exclusive events, then probability of A1 union A2 union dot 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 union A3 and so on, that will be P of A1 plus P of A2 plus P of A3 plus dot 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 P of AN plus dot dot dot. Okay. I will see some simple deductions. Probability of phi is equal to 0. Phi is impossible even. Phi is impossible event. Phi is impossible event. Probability of phi is equal to 0. Okay. Now, from set theory, what we know, S union phi is equal to S, okay, where S is certain event. Now, probability S union phi, this is equal to probability of S, probability of S equal to 1. Now here, phi and S are mutually exclusive events. Phi, and since S intersection phi is equal to phi, So since the events S and phi are mutually exclusive, that can be written as P of S plus P of phi is equal to 1. In bracket, let me write the reason. S and phi are mutually exclusive. S and phi are mutually exclusive. So that would give you P of phi 1 minus P of S. P of S is equal to 1. 1 minus 1, that is equal to 0. So this is P of phi is equal to 0. Probability of if possible event is equal to 0. Next, let us see complementary event. Now, what is complementary event? I'm not writing, just listen. What is complementary event? Okay. Suppose A is an event, then not A is the complement of A. Not A complement of A. A is the event, not A. That is, suppose A consists, if you're rolling a die, so suppose A is the event multiple of 3. Okay. So what will be the complement of A? Not multiple of 3. Not multiple of 3 means A consists of the point 3 and 6. So A complement will consist of the point 1, 2, 4, 5. Okay. So if A bar is the complementary event, complementary event of A, then what will have P of A complement 1 minus P of A. Then P of A complement is 1 minus P of A, and obviously that will be less than or equal to 1, since probability of any event is less than or equal to 1. Okay. And let us see the proof of this theorem. Okay. For any complementary event, now see, if this is the sample space, and suppose this portion is the event A. So what will be the remaining portion? This portion will be A complement. Now if we take the union of A and A complement, that will be the sample space. Okay. So clearly we can write A union A complement, this is equal to the sample space. Now also, if we take the intersection of A and A complement, their intersection is phi. Nothing is there common to these two sets. This is one set, this is another set, there is nothing common. So that is, the sets are mutually exclusive. Okay. So this implies P of A union A complement, this is equal to P of S. P of S is the certain event. By assuming the definition of probability, P of S equal to 1. So this implies P of A plus P of A complement. Why we can write that as A and A complement are mutually exclusive. So this is actually what you are getting, probability of A complement. This is 1 minus probability of, okay. Probability of A complement is equal to 1 minus probability of A. Now, in the next class, we'll see the general additivity rule. Here we have seen